Hé, hey, mijn haar!
Wow, 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 dat is echt niet oké, hè? Dat kan echt niet, hè? Alles goed, niet het haar.
Do you know that feeling when you're eating something and you think, I could have made that better on my barbecue? Today, we're going to solve that problem. And I'm going to show you how to take your barbecue flavors with you in your pocket. I'm gonna make three different typical barbecue flavors. A grilled lemon pepper, a classic barbecue, and an Italian roast. All that you can take with you in your pocket. And this is a great opportunity to finally use my smallest and cheapest grill. This is my Envelope grill. It's the cheapest grill that I own. I filled it up with red hot Kamado Joe's Big Block, and now it's time to grill. The first pocket barbecue flavor that I'm going to make is grilled lemon pepper. I'm starting by slicing a lemon, and I'm slicing it fine. This will help reduce the drying time. Now I take the cap of three red peppers and deseed them. Time to put them on the grill. For the red peppers, we're looking for a good amount of black char. For the lemons, we want caramelization. Once that is done, we can put them on a wired rack and place them in our food dryer. We'll leave them in the food dryer for 24 hours. For drying food and vegetables, you do not necessarily need a food dryer. You can also use a barbecue or a convection oven, as long as you can set it to a temperature of 60 degrees Celsius, which is around 140 degrees Fahrenheit. And it should have enough airflow, so actually your fruit and vegetables are drying. The dried lemon and pepper smell fantastic. I'm going to grind it down, take out 1/3 of the salt in my salt grinder and replace it with the dried herbs. Now it's time to shake, shake, shake it like a Polaroid. And of course we're gonna need a label to make sure that we remember what is what. Now let's do a classical version of barbecue smoked flavors. Slice the outside from the red bell pepper, peel and cut two garlic cloves in half, slice a quarter of a large onion into thin slices, grill them over the barbecue until they have a light char, place them in the food dryer for 24 hours, take the salt out of the grinder and smoke it for 3 hours. I happen to be smoking some beef ribs on the barbecue, so I can set the salt next to the beef. The fun part about smoking salt is that you can play around with the smoke flavors. You can use oak, hickory, you can use fruit flavors if you want to. Just play around with it, see what you like best. I'm using beech tree this time, and don't worry about it. If you fail, you can do it again because salt is very cheap. Grind down the paprika, garlic, and onion. Add the smoked salt to it. Give it a good mix and put it in the salt grinder. Label the jar and you have another barbecue flavor to take with you everywhere you go. We're killing it. Let's do another one. Slice one lime and one garlic clove, grill them over the charcoal and put them in the dryer. Dry the lime and garlic with some twigs of fresh oregano and thyme. Remove the herb leaves from the stalks and add all of the ingredients in the grinder. Grind them down, add them to the salt, and your Italian roast flavors are done. Now that we have three beautiful barbecue flavors in our pocket, it's time to start grilling for real. I went to the supermarket and I thought I would pick up some chicken fillets. Sadly, there wasn't any meat left of any kind. So I decided to dive into my freezer and look what I can find. And guess what? I found a 1.5 kilogram tomahawk. I guess we'll have to make do with that. I did a reverse sear on my tomahawk steak. I slowly let it come up to temperature and then grilled it off, getting a nice crust on the outside. And then finally, we took our pocket barbecue flavors and sprinkled it on our steak. Now it's time for the taste test.
I really like the flavor, but I'm not sure what I'm tasting. It's salty, of course, because they're salt.
I'm not really a fan of tomahawk.
Garlic and onion. Okay.
But I like the flavors. I'm gonna take another bite. Mm-hmm.
I like this one because it's not heavy.
Good rub.
It is chewy. When you got rubiagaiga and you got a tomahawk, the strains run in the thickness of the steak. So basically what you get is long fibers from the meat. Definitely not tender, but I love the flavors. I got some lemon and pepper here. It's my first steak. And it's amazing. Wow. Having a jar like this, a little bottle of barbecue flavors with you, so you can use it everywhere you go. You can have it on your egg for breakfast. A little bit of that smoke flavor from the salt. Grilled lemon and pepper to brighten things up on your fish. Barbecue flavors when you're eating a pork chop somewhere. You can brighten up everything. And you can take it with you in your pocket. I love this. Absolutely fantastic. Denise, we should try more steak. If you're gonna season the steaks while I cut it. Sure. Which one? We're gonna try the Italian now?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit of love. Completely different from the lemon and pepper. Better than the lemon and pepper?
Yeah.
Can I try it?
No. I'm just gonna take another cut. Put some lemon and pepper again on this. You're sticking to the Italian one?
Yeah, for now.
Oh. No, I like the lemon and pepper better. Just put it here. Pop. Take it with you. You can go wherever you like and have barbecue flavors with you. Isn't that cool? Oh, wait a minute. They're mine. We're already in trouble here. Hope you guys enjoyed this video because I got some things to sort out with Denise. And if you did, then leave us a big thumbs up. This is getting better. Thank you guys very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you think this is a great idea, let us know in the comment down below. Big thumbs up. See you guys next time. Until then.
It's Markler.
And keep on grilling. Come on, give it back. Why? You can have the...
No, we have to try this one.
What? Morrison wants one too. Which one do you want, Morrison?
Lemon and pepper.
No. I'm taking the lemon. You gotta go for the barbecue.
No, the barbecue one is boring.
Whoa, dude!
Whoa.
You're fired!